And so that really affects people with depression from getting the treatment that they really do need and deserve. So here are some physical changes to people with depression. So as I said before, people don't always realize that depression is a very serious thing and that it can affect people greatly. And that it's just, you know, some made-up concept for people to get away with. And PET scans and MRI scans have shown that there are significant changes in the brain that contribute to depression, such as changes in the amygdala and thalamus and hippocampus. So the amygdala is associated with a person recalling a certain emotion, charged emotion. And so in people with depression, it has been shown that the amygdala has heightened activity, and that contributes to their overreaction sometimes. Additionally, the hippocampus is also involved in emotion, and it has been shown that people have smaller hippocampuses if they have depression, major clinical depression. And stress is also a major contributor to this. People have found, or studies have shown that stress actually suppresses the generation of neurons. And so medications are in place to help strengthen neural connections and improve neurogenesis, just the connection of neurons. So for treatment, there is actually no treatment. Like, there's no certain cure or certain pill that you have to take in order to magically be cured. And but there are, you know, certain therapies put in place to help ease some of the effects. So for people with seasonal depression, phototherapy is one of the most commonly used treatments. And that is essentially when a person is subject to artificial light to help quite literally brighten the mood. And it helps them because seasonal depression, for those who don't know, it's when a person starts experiencing those negative feelings of depression and just general hopelessness and loneliness during times of winter months where, like, the weather is darker and drearier, so they don't really get that full, you know, lightness and brightness associated with the summer. Additionally, hotlines and talking and counseling are also proven to help, because many people find that it's easier to talk to a stranger about your emotions and your problems rather than talking to somebody that you know very well, because you're not scared of all that judgment and fear that you're going to get. Additionally,